From this time, I only went to the Mediterranean every time I've traveled. And so it was really like my patch of work. And I went gradually round. But after Morocco, and in Morocco, I met a lot of strangers as well. And, you know, one woman who's, some who weren't strangers, was the cousin of the ambassador in England. He had given me her dress, and it was the most extraordinary cuisine. And so I had all kinds of experiences in Morocco. But while I was traveling around the Mediterranean, right from the beginning, the BBC had been interested in doing a series on the Mediterranean because they had done a series on healthy food, healthy cuisine. And it ended with an event in Italy where some great special nutritionists were saying Mediterranean food is the healthiest. And because there had been an early American nutritionist who had done research in six countries, and he found that all the Mediterranean countries, people lived longer, they had less vascular diseases, a whole lot of things. And so the BBC, I was involved in that series, but just doing a Middle Eastern thing when I didn't know about the healthy values. And so they asked me, could I do a television series with them? And I did. I was more behind the scenes. I was the presenter only to present each different program, but I was the voice explaining where we were, what we did, and the television series was called Claudia Roden's Mediterranean Cookery. And so for me, this was marvelous because they paid for travels, but also we were able, because of their money, to go to all kinds of places. And also everybody wanted to help, because to be in the BBC program is something. And so we went to seven countries, and including Egypt and Greece, and we went to Spain. And for me, it was my first trip to Spain. But I had already traveled quite a lot. And so they used my contacts and my knowledge, and also my knowledge of events, to do their film. For instance, in Morocco, I knew there was going to be a wedding. And so they went out without me. They went out mostly without me to film the wedding. And it was a wedding in two houses, the men in one, the women in the other, the cooking of, and I knew the whole culture. By then I had already done a lot of finding out.